Hello everyone, good morning to all of you. Today in this video we are going to discuss about photon. Photon, what is photon? What exactly is a photon? What is its nature or what are its properties? We will discuss so many things about the photon. But before we start from quantum theory of radiation, Max Planck, popular name, you all know, you have heard Max Planck proposed the quantum theory of radiation to explain the distribution of energy with wavelength in black body radiation. According to this theory, an accelerated electron does not radiate energy continuously, but the energy is emitted in tiny packets or quantum. So, if you see this sentence, the meaning of this sentence is accelerated electron does not radiate energy continuously. Okay? When you see the electromagnetic theory of light, it is required as continuous energy, but here Max Planck told about discrete energy. It is not continuous. Instead, he said energy is emitted. You can see here, energy is emitted in tiny packets. You may say quantum. Planck described accelerated electron as a linear oscillator. Okay. The oscillator emits energy only when it passes from higher energy state to lower energy state and absorbs. This is also not a very new sentence. I think you know this sentence also, that when energy is given to an atom, or you may say it reaches to excited state, means when it jumps from lower energy level to higher energy level, it absorbs energy. But when it comes from higher to lower, it releases energy. And this is the result, or this results into emission of radiation. No emission or absorption of energy takes place when the oscillator is in given state. What does it mean? It means if the oscillator will be in given state, means in a fixed state, it will neither go from lower to higher or higher to lower. Neither energy will be absorbed nor will be released. Now, if it goes from, or if it returns from higher to lower, energy is released. Question is here, how much? See here, the smallest amount of energy which can be emitted or absorbed is h nu. In other words, radiation of frequency nu is emitted as quantum of energy E is equal to h nu, where what is h? H is Planck's universal constant, and its value is this much. The quantum is the basic unit in energy and cannot be subdivided. Okay. Quantum theory of radiation has been able to explain a number of phenomena which could not be able to explain to the classical concept. This is about quantum theory of radiation. And actually, I will focus on photon. The quantum is the basic unit of energy and cannot be subdivided. It is the atom of energy and is known as photon. So, what exactly is a photon? In physics, photon is a bundle of electromagnetic energy. It means photons are nothing but the energy capsules or energy packets. and the quantized one. Do you know meaning quantization? Here you can get energy packets or energy capsule. You can have one capsule, two capsule, cannot have two and half. So it is quantization. It is found in integral multiple as 1, 2, 3. Here any digit or any number between 1 and 2, 1.2, 1.3 not possible. Okay, so quantized one means integral multiple. It is the basic unit that makes up all life. The photon is sometimes referred to as quantum of electromagnetic energy. Photons are a basic unit of nature called elementary particles. Now, what is frequency of photon? E frequency is denoted by nu. So if lambda is the wavelength of this light, its frequency nu is equal to C by lambda. Now energy. Energy is denoted by E. E is equal to general formula H nu, which is equal to H C by lambda, because nu is equal to C by lambda. Mass. According to the theory of relativity, a mass m has an energy equivalent to mc square, where c is the velocity of light. So e is equal to mc square, or m is equal to e by c square. So mass of photon having energy h nu is equal to h nu by c square. Now we will discuss about momentum. Momentum, it is the mass times velocity. Formula is mass times velocity. Mass is this one, just you can see here this one, and velocity is c. So one c will be cancelled out. It will be h nu by c. Nu by c is equal to 1 by lambda. That is h by lambda. Protons are always in motion in vacuum. Its speed is 3×10⁸ meter per second. Now we are going to discuss its few properties. The basic properties of photon are: photon is a fundamental particle of light. They have unique property in that they are both a particle and a wave, dual character. Photon have zero mass and rest energy. Photons are elementary particles. Photon have no electric charge. Photon are stable. Photon do not decay by their own. Photon have spin 1 quantum unit. Here I want to explain this. Spin of photon is 1 quantum unit. What does it mean? It means in order to regain their original form, they need to return 360 degree. And 360 degree, 1 here represents the eigenvalue of photon. Photons carry energy and momentum. I will discuss later on also. Photons carry energy and momentum, which are dependent on the frequency. Photons interact with all charged particles, as you can see in photoelectric effect. One photon incident on the metal surface, it gives energy to the electron. Electrons leave the surface of metal. Okay. Photons can be destroyed or created by many natural processes. For example, when radiation is emitted. So these are about the properties of photons. Now, photon linear momentum in terms of wave vector. I'm going to revise. Revise in the sense that already we have seen that P is equal to H by lambda. Momentum, but same thing I will express in terms of wave vector. See here, we multiply it by 2 pi, multiply and divide 2 pi. So h by 2 pi is equal to h cut. Here I have written h cross, and 2 pi by lambda is k. What is k? K is the wave vector. So p is equal to h cross k. Photon energy in terms of angular velocity. Now we will change the expression in terms of angular velocity. See here, E is equal to hc by lambda. C by lambda is equal to nu. And when we divide by 2 pi and multiply by 2 pi, it is h cross again. And 2 pi nu is equal to omega. In the last, we want to discuss rest mass of photon is zero, which is asked in the examination as a short answer. So, try to learn this one. In a relativistic case, the de Broglie waves associated with the moving particle of rest mass m0 having a momentum p, the total energy is equal to this one. Just now, you saw that energy is expressed E is equal to mc square. Energy is E is equal to mc square. Okay. Now, okay, I am coming. Yeah. Energy is equal to mc square, but energy is equal to E is equal to mc square. Most of us, we know that energy is equal to mc square. But this is a special case of this equation. The complete version of the equation is E is equal to this one. Here m0 rest mass is velocity of light, p is momentum, E is the total energy. Okay. Now, phase velocity Vp is equal to E by p. As you know, energy is equal to energy divided by momentum is equal to phase velocity. So energy here, this one, and p is taken inside the bracket so that half comes on p square. So when you take the square root of p square, again you will get p. Now we divide by p square here. It will be this one, and here p square, p square cancel out. This one cancel out. So it is 1. Now, C square here, you can see. Here is C4, here C square, taking common C square. And when it is put outside the bracket, it will be C due to square root. Now consider de Broglie wave traveling with velocity C. This corresponds to the propagation of electromagnetic waves. The velocity of the associated particle, that is photon, is also c. Its velocity is c, which I have assumed here Vp. So if Vp is taken c, then cc will be cancelled out, and after solving we get m0 is equal to 0. This shows that the rest mass of the photon is 0, because c cannot be 0, lambda cannot be 0, h cannot be 0. So ultimately m0 is equal to 0. And these are the facts about photon. You will read it and you will understand easily. Okay. Thank you. Thank you. हो गया मेरा।